In a previous project, we took a carbon dioxide fire extinguisher and shot out a round of homemade dry ice. In this project, we're mixing our dry ice with a few other ingredients to make a delicious batch of carbonated ice cream. You might remember this CO2 fire extinguisher from a previous video. I started this project by fully discharging it into this pillowcase just to see how much dry ice we could collect. From a 15-pound extinguisher, we got over 5 pounds of dry ice. Now there's a good chance you don't have a CO2 fire extinguisher on hand, and that's okay. This works just as well with the blocks of dry ice you'd get at the grocery store. Alright, to make some ice cream, we'll just need to round up some common ingredients like these. For this recipe, I chose to use powdered sugar, some half and half, and vanilla extract. Let's start by pouring 2 cups of half and half into a large mixing bowl, followed by 1 teaspoon of vanilla and half a cup of powdered sugar. At this point, we can stir it all together until the ingredients are mixed thoroughly. Okay, it's time to put the ice into our ice cream. I'm starting with 1/4 cup of dry ice, and we'll need to mix that around gently to cool down the liquid. The great thing about dry ice is that when it sublimates, it doesn't water down the mix at all. It just vaporizes right out. When you notice that the fog stops flowing over the edges of your bowl, it's time to add some more dry ice, and you're going to want to crush this up as finely as you can. If you find any large chunks while you're stirring, take a second to pull them out and crush them up as well. It could be extremely dangerous if you accidentally swallowed one. This ice is minus 78 degrees Celsius and could leave you with internal frostbite and fill you up with carbon dioxide gas. I was a little curious to know what that might feel like, so I popped one in my mouth. Now if I continuously move the ice around with my tongue, it doesn't sit still long enough to bite me. Chewing it up into smaller pieces is a little more risky because it releases a lot more CO2, making it much harder to breathe. And the little chunks that stick in your mouth actually sting fairly sharply. But overall, I'd say it's survivable. Okay, when your cream is cold enough that it has the consistency of soft serve ice cream, you're just about done. Just inspect it one more time for hidden clumps of dry ice and keep stirring until the vapor stops completely. At this point, you can go ahead and dish out your tingly treat. You should find that your ice cream looks the way you'd expect it should, but this treat has a twist. It's fizzy. My wife gave this one to our little boy for testing, and once he acclimated to the carbonation, he couldn't get enough. Well, now you know how to make a delicious tasting carbonated ice cream using simple ingredients and a little dry ice. If you like this project, perhaps you'll like some of my others. Check them out at thekingofrandom.com.